Hi everybody, Joe Conroy, certified financial planner and author of Decades in Decisions. And in a little video series, if you haven't watched any of the previous ones, I'm going through my book and talking about different sections. So it's a financial planning book. Each chapter is a different chapter or decade in your lives. In this particular section I'm going to talk about, it's going to be from the 50s, but it could apply to a lot of different decades, and that is 401k loans or 403b loans. So what I have noticed, and a lot of times I get the question, Joe, is, you know, I'm looking for paying for my kids' college expenses. Is taking a loan from my 401k plan a good strategy? Every situation is different and unique, but generally speaking, it's very rare that I recommend a 401k loan. It is in the hierarchy of different ways to access capital, starting with cash savings, and then working your way down to credit card debt that you can't pay off. It is in the bottom half of things. So you take money out of your 401k in the form of a loan, it's not taxable, and then you pay yourself back with interest, that you pay your own interest back. And in essence, what you're doing is you're taking money that's pre-tax out, and then when you go to put it back in, you're putting after-tax dollars back in, and sure, you're getting an interest rate of whatever you want to give yourself, but you know, if you're a business owner and you make $70,000 a year and you give yourself a raise to $90,000 a year, it's coming out of your own pocket anyway. You got to figure out where that money comes from. So if you're paying your own investment returns or interest, it's not as profitable as earning market from outside sources like dividend income or growth. You know, share price goes from $10 to $12 or you name it. So, you know, when you really dig into it, it's not quite as attractive as you think it is. And you've taken pre-tax dollars and you've replaced them with after-tax dollars, and also limits what you can do when you go to leave your job. You got a couple of things that complicates things. Anyway, long story short, 401k, 403b, TSP loans, you name it, it's not all that it could be in the eyes of the average investor from my experience. So if you want to learn more, you can check out the book, talk to a qualified financial advisor, and look forward to the next section where I talk about the 60s in the book. As always, thank you for watching.